push the... Well... You know, you can just push this up against it, and then if... latch it, and if it's not the right size, say if you put this latch back too far, you can adjust the length of the latch by screwing it. One really dirty cup, and if we just keep the clean cup clean like the entire week, meaning don't put it in cement, don't, I don't know what else you can get it dirty with, but mostly just don't dip this cup in cement. We'll just use it for foam, and then we'll be able to read all the little markings on the side of it the entire week. So this is just a measuring quart cup. So the little pressure regulator right here is how you adjust the foam weight. When you turn it on at the beginning, there's no air that comes into it, right? This little valve right here is what lets the air in. So when you turn it on, can you hold this over the bucket, please? Okay. So when you turn it on, you put this switch right here, and then the pump starts going. You gotta make sure that this is turned on right here, and you just wait until liquid comes out the end over there. So hold it up high, there we go, see? And so then you know, okay, there's the water coming through, now I can turn on the air, bing! And then foam starts coming out. And then you let it run for at least 3 seconds, and then you fill up your cup, and then you turn it off, and then you weigh the foam. And so what we're going for when we weigh the foam is 90 to 100 grams per quart. Okay, so we have this little scale over here, which the scale has been teared or torn, I don't know what the right word is, past tense of tear. Okay, so we teared the scale. Okay, which tearing the scale means putting an empty cup on top of it and then pushing the tear button. And so then now it reads zero. So basically I'm not weighing the cup, I'm just weighing the contents of the cup, right? So this weighs 104 grams, which means that we need to put more air into it to make the foam lighter. So my little pressure regulator right here has a minus and a plus. I'm gonna move it just like the slightest amount to the plus. And then we're gonna weigh it again. So I'll empty this back out into there. I'll give you this cup. And so once the foam starts coming out, wait for 3 seconds and then fill the cup.
I saw it change consistency.
Yeah, right?
It got thicker.
Go for it.
Now?
Mm-hmm.
See, it got thicker.
Yeah, right, because I should have turned the... So basically when you turn it off, you should like turn the air off first and then turn the water off. Yeah, now it's 90. So that's perfect, actually. You want 90 to 100 grams per cement, which is what cement comes in standard in the United States. Those ones are 47 pounds, which is half of 94 pounds. But anyways, for a 94 pound bag of cement, you need 6 gallons of water and then 94 pounds of cement. And then we'll use foam and we will fill it all the way up to about 45 gallons of aircrete. That's how much aircrete we're gonna make. So 94 pounds of cement, 6 gallons of water, 45 gallons of aircrete.
This one too?
Yep. That one too. Okay, and then when the cement goes in, if you just pour the cement in, it's gonna make this really hard lump down in the bottom of the barrel. So as the cement gets added, I'm gonna mix it. So I'm gonna mix this one just because I'm gonna show you the way that it's supposed to be done, quote, end quote, and then I'll turn it over to all of you guys. But somebody would bring, let's have two people bring over each a 47 pound bag of cement, please.
How much cement?
I don't know, Hadar. How many bags of cement did it take?
I think the one in the house.
Yeah. That's right. So we did a 14-foot diameter one in Maui, and that one was about 65 bags. And now we usually do like 16-foot diameter domes at the workshops, and those usually take about 70, 75 bags.
Not counting the foundation.
Correct. So then if you pour the foundation out of Aircrete, then that would be like another 20 bags. So like 100 bags of cement, basically. Okay, so when we cut these bags, of course you can cut it any way you like. I'm gonna show you how I like to cut it just because I'm a weirdo. I'm a weirdo. Okay, so anyway, you cut across like this, you go down like that, and then you go like this. And then you have this nice little door that swings open when you pour the cement into it. Okay, so I'm gonna put this razor right here. And if somebody wants to take this bag right here and pour it into the mixing barrel, that'd be fantastic. I'm gonna wait until I get the mixer running, why don't you, please? Alright, go for it. Wait a second, just hold it. Basically, if you find any lumps, then I'll just stir it up a little bit more and then get on with adding foam to the top. And you also want to keep the mixer all the way down in the bottom of the barrel because that's where the heaviest cement is. And so you're incorporating always then the heaviest cement with the foam. And it's good to move it around as well the entire time in order to just get it all mixed better. Basically, if you don't mix the Aircrete well enough, the bottom ends up being really dense and the top ends up being really light. Mm. And then the top collapses and the bottom is hard as a rock. So it just kind of throws everything off. Okay, here we go. Up and down to get the stuff, just to consistently mix it. And I always plunge it 20 times. And then after I plunge it 20 times, then I'm done and we can pour it basically. So. Take it back. We just kind of like barely tip it up. I think we got it. Perfect. How many guys do you need for that? At least 6 on a normal day. But with Caden here, just do it later. I feel like it just needs to be flush on either end. And then we'll unhook all of the strings from the bungee cords. Right now we've just unhooked one because we're just going to show you one to begin with. And then come over to this side and go through the respective hole for that string.
Just go ahead and pull this all the way out.
Oh, okay, cool. I think, is that one from the other
side? As I pull this out, it releases all the strings, right?
So that thing needs to go, this little hook that we made, it needs to go through the loop and catch the loop. And I think, is that from that side, Hadar, or is it from the other side? What, can you pull the rod out?
Look at those hinges down there, you should be on it.
Oh, you're right, I am. Okay, so it's got a little hook on the end of it.
So you can, crochet hook.
It's got to wait till the rod is out.
Okay.
And now hook the rod out.
So what we can do is, here, let go.
There's another rod
over here. Oh, I got you.
So just catch the end of the hook.
I'll do that. It is like a cut-off crochet hook,
yeah.
Isn't it? That's funny.
Okay.
Here's the rod out.
I gotta pull this one out, too.
There's one rod in here.
Which right, we need to pull, so we need to pull all the rods out.
Yeah, you can pull them all out.
So when you put this onto the string on the other side, you just take it, there's a loop on each string, and you just catch the crochet hook, like the little hook at the end, on the loop so that you can pull it and quickly get it off. Okay, ready? Dun, 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 dun.
Pull more at the
slight angle.
Yeah,
I'm gonna pull a little bit at an upward.
There's something real high right there. Drum roll, please!
Yay! Beautiful! Woo. Oh, that's slick.
So that's the way that it's supposed to work.
That's slicker than snacks.
Wow. Dun, dun, dun.